Hello friends, so after covering a numerical on convolution theorem, let's move ahead with the second numerical on convolution theorem. So here I have one function of s which is different than the previous function, and let's see how to find the inverse Laplace transform of that by using convolution theorem. So let's start. So here we have to find out inverse Laplace transform of s upon s square plus a square into s square plus b square by using convolution theorem. So guys, to find out the inverse Laplace transform of this function, there are many methods. So I may use the partial fraction method to get the inverse Laplace transform. But since we are covering this problem under the convolution theorem, we are going to use that method. And also in the examination, if you get this question, then I would recommend to use convolution theorem, because that is the simplest method to get the answer. Or if you are very well with the partial fraction, then use the method of partial fraction to get the inverse Laplace transform. So let's start. So I'm going to show you the steps which we are going to use to solve the numerical, and we are going to follow those steps to get the answer in simplest way. So here on the screen there are steps. So step number one is, consider the given function as phi1 of s and phi2 of s. So what we have to do is, here in the step number 5, you can see the convolution theorem which says inverse Laplace transform of phi1 of s into phi2 of s. It means in convolution theorem we have a function which is divided into two parts, which is phi1 of s and phi2 of s. So we'll call one function as phi1 and other as phi2. So here I have s upon s square plus a square into s square plus b square. So I'll be considering it into two parts, that is phi1 of s and phi2 of s. So let's start. So here I've considered phi1 of s as s upon s square plus a square and phi2 of s as 1 upon s square plus b square. But guys, that is not a compulsion. You may consider this phi2 of s as phi1 of s and this as phi2 of s. So if you change the order also, then also you'll get the same answer, because the ultimately we should take these two functions in such a way that the multiplication of these two functions must be your question. So if you see here, s into 1, that is s, and multiplication of these two brackets is your denominator. So we have taken phi1 of s and phi2 of s correctly. Now the step number 2. So in the step number 2, we have to find out the inverse Laplace transform of phi1 of s, and it is nothing but f1 of t. And similarly, we'll find out the inverse Laplace transform of phi2 of s, which is f2 of t. So let's start. So here I'll say, therefore, inverse Laplace transform of phi1 of s equal to, so that is, now guys, value of this by the standard formula is cos of at. Now I'll call this as f1 of t, because this is the inverse Laplace transform of phi1 of s. Now let's find out for second function. So inverse Laplace transform of phi2 of s is 1 upon s square plus b square. Now guys, formula for this is 1 by b into sine of bt, and I'll call this as f2 of t. After that, let's move to the step number 3. So it says, find f1 of u by replacing t with u in f1 of t. So we got the value of f1 of t, in that I'm going to replace t with u. And then we'll follow the step number 4, in which we'll find out f2 of t minus u by replacing t with t minus u in f2 of t. So we got value of f1 of t and f2 of t. We are going to replace t with u in f1 of t, and we are going to replace t with t minus u in f2 of t. So let's start. So therefore, f1 of u equal to, so replacing t with u, we will get cos of a u, and f2 of t minus u is equal to 1 by b sine of b into t minus u. So we have replaced this t with t minus u. Now we got both the values. Now it's the last step, that is apply the convolution theorem. So by convolution theorem, the inverse Laplace transform of multiplication of these two functions is given by integration over 0 to t f1 of u into f2 of t minus u du. So I'm going to use this definition. So Now guys, let's put the value of f1 of u and f2 of t minus u. So it is cos au and 1 by b sine of bt minus bu. So now let's find out the integration of this given function. So here 1 by is a constant, I can take it outside, and we have two trigonometric terms which are multiplying each other, that is cos and sin. And guys, to find out integration of such function, we have to use the defactorization formula. So what is the defactorization formula for cos A into sin B? So guys, I am gonna tell you the formula as well, because I am sure that most of the students don't know the formula. So this is 2 times cos of A into sin of B, and it is equal to 1 upon b outside, integration 0 to t. Now here we have cos A, and where the value of A is AU, and B sin B, and the value of B is BT minus BU. But we don't have 2. What I'll do is, in my answer, I'll take this 2 as 1 upon 2. So I'll get 1 by 2 into sin of, now we are going to add these two terms. So we will get AU plus BT minus BU. So here we have added the terms. Next sign is negative sine of A minus B. So A is AU minus B. So the sine of this B will change. So BT will become negative BT and BU will become positive BU. And guys, this is with respect to u. Now I can take 1 by 2 outside, that will become 1 upon 2b, and we'll find out the integration of this term. So it is equal to 1 upon 2b, and here in the bracket we'll find out the integration. Now the integration of sine is negative cos, so we are integrating with respect to u. So this will become negative cos of AU plus BT minus BU upon the derivative of this term. So derivative of AU is A, derivative of BT is 0, and this is negative B, because we are differentiating with respect to U. Next, here negative sign as it is. For sine, again the integration is negative cos, so that will become positive. So we will get plus cos of AU minus BT plus BU upon derivative of this, that is A plus B, that is from 0 to T. Now guys, let's put the upper and lower limit. So if I put T here, we will get 1 by 2B. This will become AT plus BT minus BT, because I'm substituting UST. Now guys, BT and minus BT will be cancelled, and here we will get negative cos of AT upon A minus B. So this is the value of upper limit. Plus, let's put upper limit over here. This will become AT minus BT plus BT. Again, BT BT cancel, so we'll get plus cos of AT upon A plus B. So guys, here I'm giving this square bracket, because that is the value of upper limit. Middle sign is negative. Now let's put the lower limit, which is 0. So this will be 0, this will be 0, we'll get negative cos of BT. So minus cos of BT upon A minus B, and here we will get this term 0, this term 0. Cos of minus BT, guys, cos of minus theta is cos theta, so we'll get plus cos of BT upon A plus B. So guys, here we got the value for lower limit as well. Now let's simplify this. So this is 1 upon 2b. Now here in the first and third term, 1 upon a minus b is common, so I'll take it here, 1 upon a minus b. From here we'll get negative cos at in the bracket, and here we'll get minus minus plus cos of bt. So here I'll write in the bracket cos of bt, that is positive, minus cos of at. Now similarly, from the second and fourth term, we can take 1 upon a plus b common, and here we'll get plus 1 upon a plus b. Now cos of at is positive, will remain as it is, and this will become plus minus minus cos of bt. So guys, here if you'll see, then what I can do is I can take negative sign common from here, so that here I can take this cos of bt minus cos of at common. So here I'll write this term as 1 upon 2b. This is cos of bt minus cos of at as it is. Here I'm taking negative sign outside, so cos bt will become positive and cos at will become negative, so I'm taking it common. So cos of bt minus cos of at common, and in the bracket we will get 1 upon a minus b as it is. And guys, here we got negative sign because we have taken negative sign common, that will become minus 1 upon a plus b. Now guys, let's solve this, which is the last step. So here we will get 1 upon 2b as it is. This will become a plus b. Here I'll write down 1 upon 2b. This is cos of bt minus cos of at, and this will become a plus b. I'll write for you. Then negative 1 into this, so negative a plus b upon a square minus b square. So guys, here a and a cancelled, b and b will become 2b, so this 2b will be cancelled with this 2b, and guys, we'll get answer as 1 upon a square minus b square into cos of bt minus cos of at. And guys, let me tell you that this is the value of inverse Laplace transform of a given function. So I'm sure you understood how I applied the 5 steps of convolution theorem, and I got the answer of that given inverse Laplace transform in simplest form. Thank you very much.